In this episode of It Came From My Side of the Laundry Room, I heard it through the grapevine that Hardee's used to have some great toys, and I take a look at some of the books of the mightiest man in the universe. Stay tuned. Hi, welcome back to It Came From My Side of the Laundry Room. My name's Rob, and this week we're going to take a look at two different things. One, I guess you could call it an action figure, no, a toy? Maybe. Anyway, let's take a toy-tastic adventure. Okay, these guys were all the rage back in the day, and for a short time, Hardee's used to have them as a, you can't say a Happy Meal, or even a toy that they added to a meal. They were priced separately, and they're the California Raisins. First started as part of the California Raisin Growers Association commercials, these little claymation dudes made by Will Vinton, I think his name was. Don't quote me on that. I'm wrong a lot. But Hardee's used to have these for sale. Now, also, Applause made figures of them, but I never got any of those because, of course, they were too expensive for my parents, and they just saw them as frivolous. But you tack them onto a roast beef sandwich at Hardee's, and they're all about it. So let's take a look at a couple of them. I believe there were two different sets that came out. One were your classic, them with instruments, and then they did them in more action sport poses later on. So here's a mishmash of some of them, but we'll take a look at five different ones. Now, first off, here's one playing his trumpet. Now, this is just a piece of plastic, but for some reason, this just, oh, I'm getting all nostalgic just looking at it. I used to love the California Raisins Christmas special, and these little dudes, they mean so much. And you know the one you always wanted was the one with sunglasses. Always hard to find. And like I said, I never got any of the cool Applause ones, but I got these awesome Hardee's ones. Now, you got this dude playing the trumpet. I mean, pretty cool detail on them. This close one's blurry. It just kind of looks like a turd I'm holding playing a trumpet, but it is a raisin. Believe me. Next, let's reach in the bag. And it's one of the more extreme sports ones that came out later. This is a roller skating raisin. And look at that. He has an H on his hat for Hardee's. Now, I don't know if they were out before or they were launched with these, but Hardee's had some awesome raisin sticky buns that they had for breakfast. I don't know if they still do. What's the date on this dude? 1988. I don't know if I should feel sad about that I was 12 and still collecting these. But anyway, what's the date on this dude? Let's take a look back here. 1988 as well. Yeah. We won't talk about how old I was anymore. Okay, next was actually one of the bigger Applause ones, and this one was from 1987. And this was the singer. Now, I think my parents did finally give in and get me one, but the dude with the sunglasses was all sold out. So I got the next best thing, and that's the lead singer. And as you can see, when you buy the real ones, we'll call them, they're quite a bit bigger. There we go. As you can see, he's a little bit bigger there. So, they were a little bit, they were probably a couple bucks more than these from Hardee's. But, oh, anyway, look at that a little bit more. That's the singer. See, he's really getting into it. I heard it through the grapevine. Okay. We won't talk about that again. Anyway, here's one finally with cool shades. And he's got a surfboard. How awesome is that? He's smiling, he's happy, he's out in the sun and the fun. Now one more. Let's reach in here and see. Oh, yet another of the sports ones. Looks like I don't really have that many of the instrument ones. This one's skateboarding, so you know he's rad and extreme to the max, dude. But he kind of has a look on his face like, uh-oh. And I wonder how bad the road rash would be for a raisin. I bet that'd be pretty grisly stuff. But during the era of fingerboards, he was cool. You could, whoa, look, he's ollieing all over the place. He's having a good time. Yeah. But anyway, that was a look at 5 California Raisins toys. Most of them from Hardee's in my collection, but one is the OG original kind. But I don't even know if you call them toys. They just sit on a shelf, and maybe with the skateboarding one, do a little ollie action like I was doing. But anyway, on to the next segment, which will be a new one called... Okay, with shelf life, I'm going to take a look at some of the books I have up here. They might not fall into any certain category, but these all do have a theme, that they're all Masters of the Universe. Now, this one was actually a comic made by Golden, famous for the Golden books. I assume it's the same company. But this is the Sun... Bird Legacy. And this has some real interesting things. Ooh, and this thing's falling apart. So let's not have what happened with my Starlog episode and these fall all over the place. So let's start off. This is a paper that Skeletor is reading in the prologue on his throne. In the days of old did the warlord Dire fashion a mighty weapon called Sunbird. With it he sought to overthrow the wise and benevolent Council of Elders and claim Eternia for his own. But his evil plan was thwarted, and Sunbird was dismantled into 4 separate components. Each section was taken to a different corner of Eternia and hid forever from man. First thing Skeletor says, Dio was a fool! But this was published in 1983. And has some great imagery. Like Skeletor showing up with his horn ram. His ram horned skull staff there. This has the man-at-arms without mustache, Cringer. So this is kind of an amalgam of the cartoon and the toy line. Oh look, here's Battle Cat fighting some cool bat creature dude. Here's Stratos' people getting ready to fight an ice dragon with Evil Lyn on its back. That's pretty badass. But they kind of just look like people from Thanagarian at this point. Man-at-arms fighting some cool Black Panther Jaguar people. Here is a merman fighting Teela. He's got these cool lizard men, soldiers, bodyguards. One thing about this, I mean, the art's pretty good, but to this day, looking at it, the blacks are really black. Like, you could see where somewhere in the process a inker came in and just tightened up kind of the backgrounds. Probably to save on printing costs so that they didn't have to do halftones and stuff. But look at this violence. He-Man chopping the head off that giant snake, and we see blood. We're shooting these plant animals, catching them on fire with a laser gun. Man at arms. Duncan's a killer. Got a cool splash page of everybody fighting here. And of course it ends with Adam playing the fool. But for the longest time, I mean, this was my Masters of the Universe Bible. I mean, I had the toys, I watched the cartoon, but had to have something in print to go back to whenever I wanted and read it and see the pictures and dissect it and think of the world of Eternia. $2.95 back in the day. Great cover art. But also, I got these for Christmas one year, also by Golden, but in a Heroic Champions line of books. I don't know what else came out in it, but three books here. The New Champions of Eternia, The Maze of Doom, and Demons of the Deep. And it looks like I have them all but one called Dangerous Games. Oh, and also in the Heroic Champions line, we had Princess of Power, She-Ra, and Gobots. Yeah. But let's start with Maze of Doom and take a look at it. Now, as you can see just from the cover, a little bit of a glare there, apologize. But this is the later releases of the toy line. This came out in 1985. Got a cool picture there of He-Man. But even for 1985, they kind of went back to the toys for, like, Teela there. She doesn't look like her animated counterpart. A little TNA on Teela. Sorry, I apologize. And Skeletor totally looks out of character there. But they have Orko. It's like a mishmash, just like the comic that we just looked at. Oh, look, here's Clawful. Always a favorite. Ooh, and the size looks a little off there of He-Man riding Battle Cat. Looks like Battle Cat should be riding He-Man. Ooh. Now this is, excuse me, probably one of the worst pictures ever of Whiplash. Look, he has 5 o'clock shadow, if you can tell. It looks like they colored Bluto from Popeye green and gave him a tail. But Duncan has a mustache, so there we go. Has Cobra Khan. breathing his poison gas at He-Man. And a very cut and pasted Castle Grayskull. Very flat, just plopped down there on the ground. But what's funny is the cover, I'll show you again in a second, has the Power Armor He-Man, or Battle Damage Armor He-Man, however you want to say it. But the book itself has him in his normal bandolier armor, however you want to say it. Look how weird Orko looks. Artwork's a little rough. But anyway, that was Maze of Doom. Next is the New Champions of Eternia. And like I said, he has, it's the Armor He-Man. I don't know if he appears in this book like that. Here's Fisto and Stratos with Teela and Man-at-Arms. With some of the Eternia peasants wrapping up Stratos' arm. Does it say what happened to it? Ah, they are fighting Skeletor and his army back across the borderlands to the dark side of the planet. Our warrior suffered only minor wounds. His daughter Teela said, I wish He-Man had come back to share in the celebration. But Prince Adam's there, waving a broom around like an idiot. Now, again, that art looks a little rough. Beastman just looks like a bald guy with a beard, kind of like me, if I was orange with blue makeup on my eyes. There's a battle scene. Yeah, real rough artwork. Look at Man-at-Arms there. I'm not saying I could draw better, but if I was getting paid for it, I'd at least try. Now, this story is about four heroes that show up out of the blue. And they're awesome at everything they do. They gain favor with the king and queen. And it gives the queen's backstory of how she was an earthling that crashed land on Eternia. But then they rip off the masks and it turns into Beastman, Triclops, and Evil Lyn. It is all just a clever ruse. Then He-Man's got to fight Skeletor. And they save the day. Look at this cool parting shot, though. But it looks like He-Man could run while riding Battle Cat. Look, his feet almost touch the ground. I would always envision Battle Cat a lot bigger than that. Okay, now Demons of the Deep. With Fisto and Ram-Man. Oh, here we go. They're just chilling out, fishing. Orko looks a little bit better. Teela still dressed more like her toy than the actual cartoon. I don't know what happened to this book. Then they get attacked by a sea monster. So after Teela gets plunged underneath with the sea monster, Adam turns into He-Man and dives in after. He-Man had guessed correctly. A different sort of magic was at work, that of Skeletor, Archfiend of Eternia. in a bizarre castle beneath the sea, a perfect replica of Castle Grayskull. He gleefully prepared to meet his hostage, Teela. Yet again, same picture as before of Castle Grayskull. But look, we have Jitsu and Merman with Skeletor with his cool skull computer. I wish my PC looked like that. That'd be pretty badass. Well, here's a better shot of it.
Hurry to AOL! Let's email He-Man!
So here, Fisto and Ram-Man and He-Man show up. Get some help from the sorceress with a magic raft that quickly gets attacked by a sea serpent as well. What the heck is going on in that picture? Oh, but it's just a robot. But Merman can control sea life, so why did it have to be a robot? But here's a whole bunch of them. And they all turn out to be robots. What a ripoff. It's Eternia. There's sea serpents everywhere. And like I said, it's Merman, so he can control them. But they all save the day, save Teela, swim off, and sail on their magic raft back home. Yeah. I was still excited to get these. I'm still excited to have them. Yet again, he's wearing his armor, battle armor, but he doesn't have it inside the book. I guess they're just trying to get kids to purchase it because that's the newest He-Man on the shelves. Anyway, that's just a little look at a couple of the books I have up on my shelf. Those happen to all be Masters of the Universe. So, anyway, this has been It Came From My Side Laundry Room. So keep being rad, stay dorky, and I'll catch you next time. Peace! Hey, thanks for watching. If you liked what you saw, hit the subscribe button for some more awesome videos. We also have a couple here on the side you might be interested in. And until next time, thanks for watching, keep being rad, and stay dorky.